In today's Excel video, this is an advanced video. We're going to use the unique function, the search function, the left function, the unique function, the sort function. I may have said unique twice, and I'll show you text before. I'm Chris Menard. Here's what we're trying to do. I've got this list of orders, and I'm worried about column A. I was asked to pull out the unique product that was ordered. The order line always starts off with the name of the product. For example, A2 has slippers. It has the date of the order followed by the name of the customer that placed the order. So the data starts in row A2 and it ends down in row A101. So we have 100 orders. You notice A2 has slippers, but so does cell A12 has slippers. I just want to see slippers one time from this data. So the unique function is definitely going to be used. And here's the unique function if you haven't seen any of my videos on unique. Equal unique. And notice I picked up G2 to G11, the entire range. And when I press enter, I get the unique number of people. Bonus tip, if you wanted to count them, I would use count A. And I get the number 6. The formula is up in the formula bar above column A on my screen. But let me go back here. I don't want to count them as examples. So unique. One more bonus tip about unique. If you continue with the argument, so I used one argument that was required. There are two additional arguments. So if I do a comma, it says by column in bold. My data is running up and down. By column would be data running from left to right. So I don't need this one. But the next one, items that appear only once. So if I type in the word true, there are the two names that are in my data one time and one time only. So there's your unique function. I just showed you all arguments. Don't need that right now. So here you go with text before. I initially thought this is going to be simple. I was going to combine unique and text before, but here's text before and here's the problem here. When I do text before, on cell A2, a lot of arguments, but technically only two are required, the first two. A2 is the cell reference. What is your delimiter? I put in the delimiter and press enter, and I got slippers. Pull it down one time. I got moccasins, and I'm like, oh, I'm in business, but always, always check your data. Look at row 10, slip on sneakers. And it just returned the word slip because of the way that they put that product in there. So this did not work for me. So let me get rid of this. But I do love text before function. So now I thought, let me use the search function, but I got to use the left function too. So left, A2, how many characters, in case you're wondering what this does, the word slippers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If I put the number 8, it would return slippers. But I can't, it's not always 8 for the number of the product. So what I'm going to do, I happen to catch that the date format, October 26, 2025, every date, they're using two digits for the month. So September in A3 is 09 instead of 9. So this is going to work for me. So equals left A2. Let's search. What do you want to find? I'm trying to find that first forward slash, comma. Argument 2 is required for searches within where? Within A2. That should take care of it. And if you find the first forward slash, and we're pulling from the left, but we need to subtract 4. There is slippers. Let's see if A10 works for us. It will be good. A10, slip-on sneakers, and I have slip-on sneakers over in column F. So now this is working. If you recalled when I did the unique function, I highlighted the entire range to find what is unique. So that is why I got rid of F3 down. I need to tweak this, and I showed you this. It goes to A101, and we're going to change this from A2 through A101. And then we're going to use unique. right on the screen right now, starting in F2 down, there are the unique items from A2 to A101 showing. Bonus tip, let's go and do the sort function. If you're wondering, what in the world is the sort function? Equals sort, if I highlight all these names, I'm not asking for unique. I'm asking just to sort these. There they are sorted. So I'm just going to pop in sort in front of unique. That's what I wanted to see. That is the result that I was expecting, and I copied this and pasted the values and shared this with my team leader, and she was happy about it. Anyway, I am Chris Menard. I hope you enjoyed this video. My training for Excel, Copilot, Teams, and OneNote are available online. And I appreciate your support of my YouTube channel. Have a great day.